Welcome, welcome, family. I greet you. Welcome to Live with Chatufa. We are right on your show. We continue to give you updates of what is happening in the nation. A lot of things are happening in our country. And like we promised that during the day, we'll be giving you updates of what is happening. And later on in the evening, we shall be looking at live shows where we'll be interacting and discussing on more of what is happening in the nation. Massive corruption has hit the Zupco state-owned company and the workers unpaid for months. Very sad scenario that we see happening in the country. You can just imagine what it is that really ZANU-PF and MNANGAGWA can ever do good. It seems there is nothing that they can ever do good. The Newsday reports that disgruntled Zimbabwe United Passenger Company employees who have gone for months without pay have alleged that massive corruption is bleeding the public transporter. Just imagine, this is the company that MNANGAGWA and Tagore and Auxilia MNANGAGWA have taken over. Remember, these buses were being bought scandalously. They were bought from Belarus, and we have seen quite a lot of inflation of figures in terms of the real prices of these buses. And the stories that we have, information we have, is that these buses were being bought at a very, very cheap price, but when they came into Zimbabwe, they were multiplied 1,000 times the amount that they were bought for right in Belarus. And remember, the other last time, there were some of these buses that came, and during the rain season, people had to open up umbrellas in the bus as it was dripping. Just imagine the buses that are supposed to be new in a country would start to to rain. You are getting wet when you are on a bus. What really works for ZANU-PF? Nothing works for ZANU-PF. We thought that MNANGAGWA and his wife have taken over the Zupco company, then they are going to be running it better. But it seems they just wanted to buy the buses and then dump them and then make their profit in terms of inflating the figures of the purchases of the buses. But when it comes to the running and the administration, I'm sure they don't care about that. That's too little money. You know, collecting $1 for them, it takes too long. They just want to hit a bumper harvest, just one go. So the deal was about inflating the prices of the buses. But this is what is happening. Just imagine that these are supposed to be new buses, which are supposed to be operating and making money, to the point that a company would fail to pay its own workers. I don't know what kind of a company would that be. A company that does not recognize the importance of the workers. You have the drivers, conductors, you have the cashiers, you have people that are in the offices, you have mechanics and the like. You fail to pay those people, and how do you expect that company to run? And by the way, this is supposed to be a state-run company. How can a state fail just to run a bus company? A bus company is a company that can be run even by individuals. Many, many individuals are running buses, and they are running their companies successfully. But a whole government fails to do that. Why? Because every department of government of ZANU-PF, every ministry of ZANU-PF is running in corruption. There is corruption at high levels, MNANGAGWA being the one at the center of all corruption. And when it comes down now, coming down the ladder, you'd find that at every stage, at every level, you will find that corruption is the order of the day. And why? What do we expect in a nation that operates like that? Remember, these are people that have families. These are fathers and mothers who have to be taking some salary back home. And you expect these people to be coming back to work every day. Imagine the expenses, the food, the lunch, and things like that, and other costs that they have to cater for their day-to-day running. But then, how do you expect these people to survive? The bus is making money every day. The conductor and the driver, they go to cash in money, which they can see themselves every day. But that money cannot come back to them as a salary. What does that mean? Really, very, very bad. This is cruelty. This is evil at its highest form. So ZANU-PF really have run down Zimbabwe to the point that Zimbabwe will never recover until we get rid of ZANU-PF. We definitely have to stand and demand the freedom of the Zimbabwean people. This is not right. This is not good. Failing to pay workers is the worst thing that anybody can ever do, especially on a money-making business where the buses are making money on a daily basis. At the end of the day, the boss has to be cashing quite a lot of money. That can be even more than the salary of the driver and the conductor who are on that bus. But it's not happening with Zimbabwe. Someone up there in the hierarchies of Zupco going up as high as up to the minister, they are stealing the money. They are diverting the money. The money is going somewhere else, and instead of benefiting the immediate beneficiaries who are the workers of the company, it's not even happening. And you wonder where the money is going. And you might be surprised that all the coffers of Zupco are just being collected and they are submitted either to Tagwire or submitted to Auxiliary MNANGAGWA, and it ends there. And the little bits that will be there are also taken by those that are in top offices and in top management. And then at the end of the day, the one that suffers is the ordinary worker, is the poor driver, the conductor, and office workers and cleaners and things like that. This is not the Zimbabwe that we want. We want a Zimbabwe that caters for its people. We want a Zimbabwe that loves its citizens. We want a Zimbabwe that allows workers to start to develop, moving from one level to another. We don't want our people to remain in poverty throughout, like what we are seeing happening because of the activities of ZANU-PF. So we definitely need to continue demanding for freedom. Zimbabwe needs to be set free, and the workers of Zimbabwe must begin to work, and they see their lives developing, rising from poverty into riches, into people making a legacy and leaving a legacy for their children and people that are coming after them. But in Zimbabwe, it's just hand to mouth. It's not even hand to mouth, because it's not even enough that is available to make people be able to feed themselves and have three meals in a day. This is a very sad development. Zimbabwe really needs to rest from ZANU-PF and the failures of ZANU-PF that we have constantly been seeing happening in our country. So, family, these are some of the updates that we will continue to be giving you during the day. We shall be meeting once again later in the evening, as we'll be looking at more and more issues that are happening in our country. Otherwise, thank you so much for joining me. For those who have not yet subscribed to this channel, please subscribe. We are going to be giving you updates from morning throughout the day until we get to the evening. Very, very important for you to know what is happening around us. So subscribe, like, and share. And also invite somebody, share, and also invite someone to understand and to know that we speak about the gospel of freedom on this very channel. Otherwise, shalom, shalom, shalom. God bless you. You are blessed.